Loops in programming are a way of repeating actions. Let's look at three different kinds of loop: a for loop, a while loop, and a do while loop. All of the loop examples are attached to a game object, and we'll check the response by looking at the console. First off, let's take a look at a while loop. The while loop is used to simply perform an action while a condition is met. In this example, we have a variable called cups in the sink. We have 4 cups in the sink. While the number of cups in the sink is more than 0, we need to wash them. So we're simply looking for I've washed a cup and subtracting 1 from the value of our cups in the sink variable. So this loop will continue 4 times because we have 4 cups. Let's see it in action. And you can see we've washed the 4 cups. Next, let's take a look at the do while loop. The do while loop functions almost identically to the while loop with 1 major difference. While loops test the condition before the loop body. However, do while loops test the condition at the end of the body. This difference means that the body of the do while loop is guaranteed to run at least once. Here is the do while script. We can see that we have a Boolean variable called shouldContinue. This variable is set to false. Next, we have the do while loop. Notice the syntax for the do while loop. We start with the keyword do, followed by open and closed braces. Whatever code is between these braces makes up the body of the loop. After the body is the while keyword, followed by the conditional. In this case, the loop would only continue while the variable shouldContinue is equal to true. We can see that the variable is set to false, so this conditional will resolve to false and the loop will exit. Finally, notice the semicolon after the conditional. While loops don't have the semicolon, but do while loops do. Back in our scene, we will enable the do while script and run it. We can see that the phrase "Hello World" is printed to the console. Even though our condition was set to resolve to false in the beginning, the body of the do while loop always runs at least once. Next, the for loop. This is probably the most common and flexible loop. The for loop works by creating a loop with a controllable number of iterations. Functionally, it begins by checking conditions in the loop, seen here as I is less than num enemies. And if the condition is met, it carries out the instructions in the loop's body, meaning what is between the curly braces. After each loop, known as an iteration, it can optionally increment a value, seen here in the third argument, where I is being incremented by 1 each time. This process then starts over. Let's look at this from a coding standpoint. The syntax for this has 3 arguments. First off, we introduce a variable that is known as the iterator. This is used to count through the iterations of the loop, meaning the loops themselves. The second argument is the condition that must be true in order for the loop to continue. Finally, the third argument defines what happens to the iterator in each loop. Usually, this means adding to the iterator in order to step through the loop. It's common in programming to start counting at 0. So, for the first loop, I will be 0, and then the operation I++, adding 1 to I, will be performed. Then, on the second loop, I will be 1, and so on. The loop will continue until I is no longer less than the numEnemies variable. So we have an integer called numEnemies, which is set to 3. Once this loop has happened 3 times, I will be equal to the value of numEnemies, and therefore the loop will not be run again, as the validation condition will be false. We will not see the message creating enemy number 3 in the console, because when I is equal to 3, it will no longer be less than numEnemies, and so it will not run the commands in the body of the loop. In this example, we're logging the value of I to the console alongside the text creating enemy number. We're using this to demonstrate iterating through a loop along with a potential practical application of this technique. Put simply, any operation that you need to carry out a defined number of times can be placed within a for loop. Let's see it in action. And you can see it logs to the console 3 times. First, showing the value of I is 0, then 1, and then 2. There's a lot of flexibility in what you can do with different loops, and you should always consider using them when repeating different actions based on certain conditions.